This is the TV Today Network, and you are watching Headlines Today.
Welcome to the Right to be Heard Town Hall. The Indian civil aviation sector is passing through a turbulent air pocket. Who's to blame for the mess in the skies? Joining us on our program today, Union Civil Aviation Minister Ajit Singh. We've got concerned citizens in the audience. We've also got stakeholders in the aviation sector. Thank you very much, Minister, for joining us on the Right to be Heard program.
You have taken three initiatives, that is deregulating the ATF imports, allowing FDI. I mean, these are good things, but we were under the impression that these benefits will be passed on to the consumer. But instead of the benefits going to the consumer, what has now happened is that the baggage allowance has decreased. Now, international tourists who are coming in from all over the world, the baggage is 20 to 23 kilos. On Emirates, it's 30 kilos. Now, all of a sudden, without any notice, all the airlines form a cartel and decrease the baggage allowance to 15 kilos, and the passengers are stranded. There are people who don't have money. They prepaid for this.
You know, most of the airlines in international arena charge you for checking in baggage and for every kilo. Please see what's happening. First you want international type of business and service and everything. Then look what's happening in the world. And Indian passengers, every will tell you, carry much more baggage than passengers anywhere in the world. अगर कहीं पांच दिन के लिए जा रहे हैं तो दस दिन का सामान और कपड़े लेके चलते हैं वो. सी दिस कॉस्ट मोर फ्यूल, मोर बैगेज, मोर फ्यूल कॉस्ट. सी दिस बिजनेस इज वेरी कॉम्पिटिटिव, द मार्जिन्स आर वेरी थिन.
वन मोर
एंड ओनली टू एयरलाइंस हैव डन इट सो फार. गवर्नमेंट हैज नो से ऑन दैट.
द आईएटा 2012 रिपोर्ट सेज दैट विद इन द नेक्स्ट फ्यू इयर्स इंडिया वुड बिकम द थर्ड लार्जेस्ट aviation country in the world. You can also take one or two other historic steps. Why don't you set up a long-term transparent aviation policy for the country?
Aviation Authority of India, we are setting up. We have sent it to the cabinet. We are planning to get navigation as a separate corporation. That is in the works. Bilateral policy, when I changed it, that every airline will be given the rights. We recently, cabinet has approved the hub policy. So all these things are taking place.
I know. That's why I'm talking about the future. My only submission, sir, is that if the government, and I'm not talking about the aviation ministry, if the government can fix the rate, a higher limit rate, for a taxi from airport to the hotel, I'm not saying that you completely regulate the whole issue. What I'm saying is Delhi-Bombay, if the direct operating cost of an airline is, let us say, 5,000 rupees, you give them an upper limit of 10,000 rupees, double it. But it cannot be. Cannot be exploitation.
See, you are right. See, although the law gives a ministry to regulate fares, according to 1934 Aircraft Act, we are empowered, but we are not going to regulate it. But we are planning for quite some time but it's been taking time to set up a economic cell which will not regulate but just monitor every fare. We want to capture the data by a computer that analyze it and then present to public that this airline is charging that much fare, that many buckets of fare, so many high price, so many low, and then let public decide. So that is in the works.
Okay, so we're completely out of time on the program. To all our guests for having joined us on the Right to be Heard Town Hall, and also to the Minister for coming and answering all the burning questions. Thank you so much for joining us on the Right to be Heard Town Hall. We'll be back next week at the same time. Till then, for news and updates, continue watching Headlines Today. Thanks for tuning in.